Ten bright stars through the perilous fight. For the ramparts we watch, where so gallantly streaming, and rockets burn the world's blessing eater. They prove through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say just that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land and of the free and the home of the
on over 30 radio stations in western Pennsylvania. And on the net with over 10 schools and hundreds of live and archived broadcasts at www.msasports.net. Anytime, anywhere, always there. We are the MSA Sports Network.
Welcome to exclusive coverage of the 2016 PIHL Penguins Cup High School Hockey Playoffs, only on the Management Science Associates Sports Network. The High School Hockey Playoffs at MSASports.net are sponsored by the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena, by J&J Distributing, by First Commonwealth Bank, by Carlo University, by ProGrass, by Dunkin' Donuts, and by Management Science Associates.
The third meeting of the year between a pair of Class AA Western Division rivals carries the biggest stakes, a berth in the PIHL Penguin Cup Championship game. It's semifinal game number one as the Bishop Canavan Crusaders battle the Baldwin Highlanders. Along with Mike Azadian, I'm Don Rebel. We welcome you to our exclusive coverage of the PIHL Penguin Cup playoffs. Two teams probably not expected to be here tonight, Michael. You have the Baldwin Highlanders. Black and purple are their colors. They are red hot here in the postseason. They beat Hampton in the first round 4-3 and then stunned top seed Moon 3-1 in the quarterfinals. Bishop Canavan came in as a 5 seed but had the tough task of taking on powerhouse Latrobe in round in the quarterfinals in Greensburg, and the Crusaders impressive in a 5-1 win.
And you know what? Both of these teams have talent and can score goals. They also could give up a lot of goals. Bishop Canavan scores almost 5 goals a game but gives up 3.5. Baldwin scores almost 4 goals a game but gives up 4.25 goals a game. These teams are up and down all year long. Baldwin started the year off hot, winning their first 4 games. Then they lost 5 of 6. And one in the middle of the season, and at the end of the season, lost 4 of 5 coming into the playoffs. And as you said, hot in the playoffs in their game against Moon, scored 2 power play goals. Their goaltender stood on his head, did a tremendous job, did Cole Shannon, keeping pucks in front of him, and their defense limited Moon. Moon just took a couple of too many penalties. Baldwin took advantage with 2 power play goals, and that's how they advanced to the semifinals. Bishop Canavan saw them earlier in the year in a barn burner at Armstrong, in a game that Armstrong won 8-7. They can score in bunches, but they can also give them up on bunches. Not sure what to make of this game. It could be a high-scoring affair, Don, but then again, if both teams play as they're capable, we could have a defensive battle as well.
I mentioned third meeting of the year. They met way back in October, October 8th to be exact, with Baldwin beating Bishop Canavan 4-3. The Tyler Rush, Paul Kinnear, Dom Carlino, and Kenny D, the 4 goal scorers for Baldwin in that victory. Bishop Canavan winning in the most recent matchup on January 18th as Thomas Krivak scored 3 goals, all 3 goals coming in the third period of a 7-4 win. Matthew Wiedhorn also added a pair of goals for Bishop Canavan.
This Bishop Canavan team lost their first 2 games of the year, then reeled off 5 straight, and a little bit of a struggle in the middle of the year going 2-3, and then really turned it on. Won 7 of their last 10 games, and that is why they're playing so well. Bishop Canavan, you mentioned Thomas Krivak. He scores 1.77 points per game. They have 7 guys that score over a point a game. Krivak, Alec Bosnick, and Lucas Krukowski, all over 10 goals this year. And those three all over 30 points. They are the main guys, but a lot of guys contributed through the year with at least 9 other guys with over 5 goals. Baldwin, Paul Kinnear leads them 2.05 points per game. He leads them in goals with 29. Max Milan, almost at 2 points a game. You also hear a lot of Tyler Rush and Kenny D. Kenny D, the defenseman, he'll take faceoffs. He's a tremendous skater. He'll do a lot to get the puck out of their zone. You will hear a lot of Kenny D today, and watch out for him. If he gets loose, he could really burn Canavan. He is one of the better players I've seen this year.
Cole Shannon, starting netminder for the Baldwin Highlanders, and Nico Borghini, he's a good one, in between the pipes for Bishop Canavan, a false faceoff. Canavan Crusaders, navy blue shorts, white tops, navy blue numerals, sky blue trim. Baldwin, black tops, black shorts with the gray numerals and the purple trim. And we are underway. Puck thrown wide of the Baldwin cage. Now played behind the Highlanders' net. Bishop Canavan's Alec Bosnick digging for it. Throws it in front through traffic. Comes to the left point but unable to handle it. There is Bishop Canavan's Gian Oliver. Baldwin now drives it into the Baldwin zone. In on goal. Never got to the net. Stood up defensively by Bishop Canavan. Was Baldwin's Mark O'Hanlon. Now the Crusaders back and forth action early on in this one. Played into the Baldwin zone around the boards. Krukowski backhands it to the back of the cage. There it's broken up and picked up by Baldwin. O'Hanlon is able to get it out. Takes a hit for his troubles. And now Bishop Canavan out of their own zone. It's Krivak. A little dump pass in. Knocked down by Antonio for Baldwin. He gives it up at center red. Rabchak has it poke checked off his stick. Back into the Bishop Canavan zone. Krivak for the Crusaders behind his own net reverses it. Rabchak along the near boards can't get it out. Now he's going to skate back behind his net. Throw it off the boards. It goes right to Kinnear. He tried to kick it ahead. Make a play to himself. Now comes to the side of the cage. Turning shot rolled off the stick of Baldwin. It's Max Millen. Now Millen tries to tee one up, and he missed on the one-timer in front. Baldwin back. Rabchak tried to push it ahead. Pinned along the boards. Millen, double team in his own zone, loses his stick for Baldwin. Rabchak try to push it ahead to Daniel Tkach. Broken up, and here comes Baldwin back, 2-on-2. Rush will throw it to the net. Borgini, I don't know that he was expecting that. Makes the blocker glove save and paddles it aside. Early on, no score. Bad angle shot, a quick one unleashed by Max Millen of Baldwin, stopped by Borgini. Non-stop action back and forth early on as the Crusaders clear out of their own zone.
Took them a while to get it out of the zone. They had some problems getting it out of their zone.
Dumped in. And Bishop Canavan plays it out and offside as Alex Bosnick tried to sneak in early on that left wing side.
First 3 minutes, the feeling out process. Neither team getting caught in any odd man breaks. Both teams' defenses, both teams' coaches realize the defense is going to win championships. You can't take too many chances early on. You don't want to get behind. Don't want to have to play from behind. Baldwin did not play from behind in their playoff game. Led 1-0, and eventually game was tied, and a power play goal to make it 2-1 and a late goal to make it 3-1, so they never played from behind in their first round game.
Kirk for Baldwin from center red flutters it in on goal. Nico Borghini makes the save, and he holds on, but it's going to be offside against Baldwin as the Highlanders were in the zone before the shot came in, and faceoff all the way back in the Baldwin zone.
That's three times they've fluttered a puck in, as you said, on Borghini. Maybe they got a book on him. Test him early with odd shots from long distances. Make him make the saves.
Faceoff win, Oliver from the left point through traffic. Good save by Shannon. His first big test of the evening. Highlanders behind their own net. O'Hanlon takes a hit, cannot clear. Puck played back behind the Highlanders' net. Pressure by Krakowski goes to the left point. Oliver fakes a shot. Now he'll fire. Blocked down before it ever got to the cage. Oliver, nice job. Keeps it in, at least momentarily. Now O'Hanlon will dump it out. Look out. Behind the defense. In on goal. And wristed one wide is Kenny D for Baldwin.
He tried that right corner. Just missed it. He was wide open. We got a guy down.
Krakowski in 2-on-2. Shoots and scores. Carlino is down at center red. Krukowski took advantage, going top shelf over the left shoulder of Cole Shannon, and Bishop Canavan strikes first.
I tell you what, I don't know what happened at center ice, but there was a collision, a good check, didn't seem like anything bad. Right after D just misses top shelf, come back and Krukowski scores on Shannon, who didn't have the angle cut down, Don. He wasn't far out of the net, and he got beat. We'll get the assist as soon as they let us know.
I think a couple players sort of froze up thinking there would be a whistle after the big collision. But no whistle. Keep going. Krakowski shelves it, and the Crusaders lead 1-0. Now, great opportunity in front. Daniel Tkach fanned on the one-timer. Back the other way. Kinnear hits the brakes for Baldwin. Has it. Fires, and he scores! Paul Kinnear. Hit the brakes, waited, and fired one low. Past Nico Borghini, Baldwin wastes little time in tying this game up.
Well, again, these teams have a lot of talent on offense. Both teams at times can score a lot of goals, and that's the way that Canavan plays, that back-and-forth fire wagon hockey. Baldwin's more than willing to play that kind of game. We thought we might have a barn burner in a high-scoring game, and it looks like that right now. After the first 3 minutes, didn't see much. All of a sudden, a lot of scoring chances, and it's 1-1.
The Baldwin goal. Highlanders into the zone. It's Antonio. Drop pass to nobody. Picked off by Bosnick. Back comes Krukowski for Bishop Canavan. Dumps it behind the net. All the way around, kept in by Krukowski. There's Lucas and there's Thomas Krakowski, the brothers for this Bishop Canavan team. That is Thomas Krakowski, who feathers it in, knocked down by Baldwin, and they get it back to center red.
Big response by Baldwin, Don. As we said, you don't want to play from behind against good teams in the semifinals, and to get a goal after missing a goal and having a guy down, it's huge.
Back at his own net, Tkach for Bishop Canavan turns it over, and a quick shot by the Highlanders, stopped by Borghini, and he was alert to make that save.
The Bishop Canavan goal, Lucas Krukowski. Assists go to Joshua Ruffing and Alec Bosnick at 3:27. And then a mere 24 seconds later, Paul Kinnear scores, assist by Nicholas Antonio.
Oh, D fires in front after yet another Bishop Canavan turnover. May have hit his own teammate down in front. That was Dom Carlino. Carlino having trouble keeping his skates early on in this one. That was a great opportunity for D. Now ahead, here come the Crusaders. TCAC goes, gets it, and is hit off the puck in the near corner. Islanders clear off the glass. Tied at one. 11 and a half minutes left, first period. Winner next Monday night at the UPMC Lemieux Sports Complex, the new building in Cranberry, for the championship. Great opportunity there for TCAC, but he fanned after he got the puck from behind the net. Baldwin's Cole Shannon was looking the wrong way. It was a wide open net, but he had the puck roll off his stick. Now the Crusaders come back in the zone, and it's Krivak. Krivak fires. Good save by Shannon from the right wing side. Islanders clear. Tomas Krakowski tried to dump it in. Instead, the Highlanders whack it deep in the Bishop Canavan zone.
A lot of back and forth, a lot of skating. Good skating teams and a lot of end-to-end action.
Crusaders come back wide open. Hockey early on in this one with teams going back and forth on the rush. Lucas Krukowski, bad angle shot, goes sailing wide.
He tried to go far corner again on Cole Shannon.
Now here comes Maximilian back for Baldwin. 1-on-3, tried to feather in front, hoping that Kinnear would be coming late. Never happened. Crusaders back the other way. 2-on-3. Good shot on goal by Matt Wheathorn, and the glove saved by Shannon.
You know, you mentioned D, and the one thing about him, if you keep giving him chances, he's not going to go all game long missing. He missed on the far side on the breakaway, missed again. If they leave him open too much, he's going to dent the scoreboard, there's no doubt. I think the most talented Baldwin player for sure.
Face off to the left of Shannon. Now we have a high stick on the puck.
And you know, D's out there every other shift. The one thing about Baldwin, they don't have as deep a bench as Bishop Canavan. You're going to see their stars by the second period. The key for them not to be too tired. There's a lot of times that D, Millen, and Co. are out there quite a bit. They don't get a ton of rest.
Face off in the Bishop Canavan zone, won by the Crusaders. Storming out of his own zone was Sam Rabchek, but he loses the puck before he gains it into the blue line. Now an offside call against Bishop Canavan.
Now all of a sudden things have really slowed down after the first 3 minutes of feeling each other out. All of a sudden 5 minutes of end-to-end action. Now the last 2 minutes just puck out of play, high stick, icing. Tends to slow down a little bit.
In the Baldwin zone, Highlanders clear out. Kuzma for Bishop Canavan. At center red, now the puck is a hot potato. Played into the Baldwin zone. Nice move, and a Crusader Krivak goes flying, and a penalty coming up on Baldwin.
Should be interference, but they're going to call a trip. Interesting. He let go of the puck, so he doesn't have the puck. Then he took him down. I think if he takes him down like that, it would have been a legitimate check. But the fact that the puck was gone, you're going to see our first power play, and it's going to be for Bishop Canavan. That's one thing. The Baldwin Highlanders, one of the biggest reasons they won against Moon, took advantage on the power play. They were 2 of 5 on the power play. That's a pretty good percentage. That's 40%. They're going to have to kill a penalty here, though.
The Baldwin penalty, number 19, Luke Kirk. 2 minutes for tripping.
Crusaders set up with the man advantage, looking to break the 1-1 tie. Work it behind the net, feathered in front, missed. Kuzma has it, fires, block. comes to Thomas Krakowski. He blasts with the left point. That's blocked, and that hurt. One of the Highlanders down. Kinnear wins the battle from Krakowski and is able to clear out.
Yeah, you're right. We do got a guy hurt.
That is Dan Figueroa. Wants to get to the bench, but he's going to try to skate it off because the puck is back in the Baldwin's zone.
I think it hit in the gut. I don't think it's on the leg. I mean, he just really took it hard.
Kuzma left side to Krivak. He had it pop off his stick, but it comes back to Kuzma. Now Krakowski. Back to Kuzma. Left point. Fire. Block. Off the skate of Max Millen and out of the zone. And look out, here comes Kinnear shorthanded, fires, and a good save by Borghini.
That's what Baldwin does, Don. It's a big thing they did against Moon. Just pack it in on that net and give up their body for the block shot.
Krukowski tried to leave it for Krivak. They're both battling for the puck in the Baldwin zone, near side. Now set over by Bosnick, broken up by Millen, and he's able to clear it out.
Pretty good penalty kill here so far, first minute 30.
Krivak into the zone, look out, right wing side, fired, and a good right pad save by Shannon. Along the near boards, Bosnick goes to the right point. That's Jake Kuzma. Kuzma, Krakowski back to Kuzma. Now they go near side to Oliver. Oliver looks, fires through traffic, hit off the leg of Kenny D and goes wide. Bishop Canavan, though, total control in this power play, which has 1 second left, and it comes out of the zone. So a successful kill. Look out of the penalty box. Kirk knocks it ahead. Here comes Lump down the left wing side. Back to Kirk. He's plowed as he gets a shot on goal, and Borghini makes a save. Now Borghini was able to stick it away from a Highlander. Tyler Rush now behind the net. Delay penalty coming up. It's going to be on Bishop Canavan. So Baldwin, after killing the man advantage, will go on the power play.
Well, let's talk about the Bishop Canavan power play. Don, at least three times they passed from the corner back out to the point, and the pass was not accurate. Just 2 feet off to the right, hits a stick, goes out of the zone. Another time, a guy wide open at the point, pass out to him. He's got to come out to the point further out to get the pass. The passes weren't accurate, therefore they could not get good shots. And the passing really, really hurt Bishop Canavan on that power play.
Bishop Canavan, penalty number 29, Ian Oliver.
So now the Highlanders set up with a man advantage. Roughing penalty on Oliver is the call. Krakowski in his own zone. That's Thomas Krakowski, the defenseman, trying to clear out. It goes around the boards, and it does clear out. Rabchak with pressure, shorthanded for Bishop Canavan. Now it's going to be Nick Antonio for Baldwin. Gets it to Millen. Into the zone comes Kinnear. Draw pass to the left point. Kinnear has it along the near boards, comes out, rockets one wide of the cage. He was trying to go top shelf. Antonio. Kinnear along the near boards, back to Antonio, try to pass over, broken up by Rabchak, and he's able to clear deep. Kenny D quickly for Baldwin. Up to Tyler Rush. Rush into the Bishop Canavan zone, hits the brakes, and a drop pass to nobody, comes all the way back to the Baldwin blue line. D to Millen. Millen down the right wing side, looking for Kinnear. Drops it to him. Nowhere to go. Kinnear along the near boards. Throws it in front. Man there. Quick shot and a goal. Max Millen on a one-timer. A power play effort puts Baldwin on top for the first time at 2-1.
Well, the power play for Baldwin, exactly, it's completely different than Bishop Canavan. The passing was there. Pinpoint passing, left to right point to corner, corner to far corner. They move the puck around, and then D, as quick as he is, goes in the back. Long lead pass, great passing. Never let Canavan get their guys to the bench, and you just wear them down, and a pass in front, and Millen takes advantage 2-1.
So a good power play kill followed by a power play goal as the Cinderella Highlanders on top 2-1.
A lot of confidence with this team right now. They're a very good skating team.
Now back into the Baldwin zone, Easton Tamburi back behind his own net. Dodges one forechecker, dodges another, and a nice pass up the ice. It's Ross Zofson throws a soft shot on goal. Borghini makes a save and holds on.
These two teams, again, Don, when you're talking about these two teams, they both, again, very good skating teams. They take some chances. They give up some goals. You know, but when they're hot, they're hot. They're both hot in the playoffs right now. Offense is winning for them in the playoffs. You like when I say you're talking about these two teams.
Ode to your sibling.
Have you heard that before?
Yeah. Rabchak crosses the Baldwin's blue line, wrists it in all the way around the boards. Kinnear gets it out. Islanders tried to get an odd man rush, but they were unable to get it from Figura to Rush. Back behind the Baldwin net. 4:20 left, first period, 2-1 Baldwin. Leading Bishop Canavan. The other semifinal game in Class AA coming up on MSA after this one. It's 2-3.
You know, Don, another thing, too, about these teams, they're playing on good ice. This is one of the best ice surfaces around here, other than, you know, Console Energy. And both teams with good skaters, that's why we're getting this back and forth. A lot of the puck's not getting delayed all the time with the bad ice that we see at some of these other arenas.
Islanders clear out. Our apologies for our video sound. I think we got that issue worked out. Video and audio the rest of the way for the semifinals the next three nights and then next Monday and Tuesday for the four Pembroke Cup title games, PIHL finals at msasports.net. Back in the Baldwin zone. Armstrong and Mars is the second semifinal. Oh, by the way, Carlino down the left wing side for Baldwin. Throws it in front, nobody there. In a black and purple jersey to tip it home. Played up in the air. Nice job keeping it in, at least momentarily. Kenny D riding that blue line.
He's so calm with the puck. Doesn't make rash decisions. Doesn't just wildly fire the puck. He just calm and cool.
Boy, D, another nice job. He knocked the puck down at the left point. And as he was sort of falling out of the zone, hard wrist shot on goal, the Borghini to make a nice save. And then it's cleared by Bishop Canavan, icing on the Crusaders.
And you mentioned D. He does a lot of little things like that in a game that just a lot of people, it won't come on the scoreboard, won't be on the score sheet. Smart moves at the point, getting a puck in the corner, beating three guys to the puck, things like that. He's so fast.
Face-off win by Baldwin. One-timer by Kinnear goes sailing wide of the far post. Crusaders struggling a little bit to get it out of their own zone. Now they finally do. Rabchak over skates. Millen has it for Baldwin. Rush knocks it in deep, goes for the chase. First one touching the puck, Thomas Krukowski for Bishop Canavan. He has it, plays it off the boards, and now the Crusaders come down. Around a man, that's Thomas Krivak. Pushes it behind the net. No dump pass, too hard for TCAC, and broken up, and the Highlanders back to center red. They turn it over. Figura too hard on the pass. Krukowski has it. Tried to get it to Rabchak, broken up by Millen. Millen pushes it ahead for Kinnear. Kinnear, big collision. Both players down, and I think Kinnear might be the guilty man as he lost his balance and sort of reached out and grabbed Bishop Canavan's, trying to see the number. Is that Glenn G and Oliver? It is.
Yeah, I think that's going to be the call. It's going to be interference. He lost his balance, didn't really do it on purpose, but still it's interference nonetheless. That's a good call, and it'll be another power play for Bishop Canavan. 0-for-1 on the power play right now. You mentioned Mars and Armstrong, two teams that seem to be in the playoffs all the time. Mars moving up from single A, and in the semifinals in their first
Both
year.
Both were in the finals a year ago. Armstrong losing to Erie Cathedral Prep in their first year of existence. And Mars, as you mentioned, winning the class single A title, shot off the side of the cage by Kuzma as he came down the left wing side. Now center point, Bosnick shot knocked down, and Millen not only with the block but the clear for Baldwin.
Oh, they have at least a half a dozen blocks, does Baldwin, on the power play. Amazing how they just, they're like the New York Rangers, they'll just jump in front of pucks as the puck goes into the bench. They just get in that tight box in front of the net and protect their goaltender, and it's going to take a rebound. Or it's going to take something to beat this goaltender, like we saw coming down on the fly on a two-on-one, beating him like that. But it's going to be tough. If he can see the puck and he's got his defenseman jumping in front of pucks, it's going to be hard to score goals against
him. Shot blocking, as Josh and Adam mentioned in our semifinal preview in the PIHL notebook on MSA, on our articles on the front page. Check it out. They mentioned the shot blocking. They've only, Baldwin allowed 41 shots in two playoff games. Bosnick down the right wing side. Oh, he looked like he beat Shannon, but it hit off the near post. It might have hit Shannon's skate and then the post. And then Shannon was able to clear, and now Baldwin clears. But 41 shots in two playoff games, pretty good.
Very good. Very, very good. They've all of a sudden not playing well. Like I said, 1-4 in their last five games heading into the playoffs. You never would have thought they would be this good. And all of a sudden, they're playing tremendous defense. It's like they got together and said, hey, look, let's play harder and play good defense.
Broken stick, trying to kick it in is Kuzma for Baldwin, or for Bishop Canavan. Baldwin's going to be able to clear. 30 seconds left. We'll go by that in the penalty, which is 1 second ahead. A broken stick by Kuzma. He's trying to make a centering pass, and his stick snapped.
Yeah, when you have the composite shaft and you have those glued blades in there, sometimes it looks like the blade and the stick are intact. It just, the glue came out and it just popped out. Happens. Not them old wooden one-piece sticks anymore, Don.
Really?
It's a different age, man, than when you played.
Huh.
Back in your backyard with a...
No, we didn't play in the backyard. That's,
yeah, the tennis courts down the road.
Millen shorthanded from the right point. Looked like handcuffed Borghini, but he makes the save. 18 seconds on the man advantage. Now 15 seconds in the penalty, or the period. One last rush for Bishop Canavan. Going wide is Bain, turned aside, and it's cleared by Baldwin. Oliver tried to knock it in deep, knocked down by Figura. He's able to clear back to center red as the horn sounds. And we are done with period one. Double A semifinals, Baldwin 2, Bishop Canavan 1. We will continue our exclusive coverage of the PIHL Penwood Cup playoffs right here on the MSA Sports Network.
Right now, when you refer a friend to open a new personal or business checking account at First Commonwealth Bank, you can earn a generous cash reward. It doesn't even have to be a friend. Could be a relative. Could be a Bruins fan. Could be that guy over there with the weird hair thing going on. It doesn't matter. Refer anyone to open an account and it will really pay off for you. They'll even get a cash reward themselves, no matter who they root for. First Commonwealth Bank, member FDIC. Learn more at a local branch or visit fcbanking.com.
Hit the ice at Mount Lebanon Ice Center, offering the most comprehensive instructional programs in the area, including hockey, figure skating, and learn-to-skate classes for all ages and ability levels. Classes start soon along with senior and developmental hockey leagues. Mount Lebanon Ice Center also hosts Friday night teen skates and Friday after-school skates for younger children. Birthday party packages also available. Mount Lebanon Ice Center, serving the South Hills for more than 35 years. Call 412-561-4363 or go to mountlebanon.org.
Own your piece of hockey history with a Penguins game-used jersey. Visit J&J Distributing at www.jjdistributing.biz and check out one of their largest selections of Penguins game-worn jerseys from your favorite Pens, past and present. Or call 724-752-1556. J&J Distributing buys, sells, and trades some of hockey's most prized possessions, including the Penguins' game-worn jerseys, Penguins' practice jerseys, minor league jerseys, and new and game-used equipment. Browse their inventory today at www.jjdistributing.biz.
Don Rebel, Mike Azadian, second period underway. Bishop Canavan scored first. Baldwin tallies twice. 2-1 Highlanders in this semifinal contest. Crusaders in their own zone. Work it out. Try to dump it in deep. Knocked down by Baldwin's Luke Kirk. And he's able to clear it out. And then clearing it into the bench area is Gian Oliver for Bishop Canavan.
Dawn, Bishop Canavan now 0-2 on the power play as their power play just ended. Bishop Canavan, you mentioned their goal. Lucas Krakowski, assisted by Joshua Ruffing and Alec Bosnick. Baldwin Paul Kinnear scores at 3:51. And then Max Millen scores on the power play. Rush and Kinnear with assists. 2-1 Baldwin after one.
Into the Bishop Canavan zone. Islanders, Kinnear has it behind the net to Chamburi on the near point. Tried to go back, but Bosnick sniffed that out, broke it up, pushes it ahead into the Baldwin zone. Overtakes the Highlanders' Luke Kirk, who is sent flying. Now behind the net, Bishop Canavan has it, centering in front, nobody home. Baldwin cannot clear out. Kept in by Lucas Krakowski, throws it behind the Baldwin net. Bishop Canavan trying to get some momentum going here with this shift. They'll once again keep the puck in. Bosnick turns, tries to feed Wheathorn, but he has it broken up. Tyler Rush for Baldwin comes out of his own zone. Cross ice pass Kinnear, and he works it up to Millen, who pushes it ahead. Krakowski, it's Tomas Krakowski for Bishop Canavan. Takes a big hit along the near boards by Millen. Still, though, battling for the puck. Good big defenseman for Bishop Canavan. Now the Crusaders. Thomas Krivak has it with a burst of speed through the neutral zone. Down the right wing side, Krivak still with the puck. Holding on, backhand pass in front, broken up by Baldwin, and they counterattack. Pass too hard for Carlino. Kuzma takes it center red. Off the far boards, dumps it behind the Baldwin net. First one to touch for Baldwin, Nick Antonio. Now a cough up, and TCAC has it for Bishop Canavan behind the net. Goes to the right point to Bain. Back to TCAC. They set up almost as if they're on the power play. The Crusaders do. Behind the net. Getting much more positional play here in the start of the second period. The Crusaders are. Krivak has it behind the net. Avoids a couple of Baldwin players. Comes out. Bad angle shot. Boy, he had Shannon on, but he couldn't tee it up. Shannon has had a couple of problems here, Mike, when the puck is behind his own net, locating, and has been out of position a couple of times, but Bishop Canavan has not been able to make him pay.
And his defense is pretty good. They'll line up along the line. It prevented Bishop Canavan from getting the passes out.
Right point, good shot by Baldwin. On goal, Easton Tamburi, and the save by Borghini. Now back the other way. Bosnick fires, and he scores! Alec Bosnick! Good wrister low, beats Shannon and ties the game at two.
Again, the way to beat them is coming in on the breaks. That's the two goals they have. And when you're set up in the offensive zone, when Baldwin has all their defense back, it's almost impossible to score against them. But on a break, it was an even break, 2-on-2. But they snap a shot by him, and he just didn't seem ready for it. Donnie went down late, low shot. They've got the book on him, keep the shots low. First one was up high, this one low, and we are tied at two. Pretty good back and forth action the first 3 minutes of this period. Both teams getting a few chances, but it seems Bishop Canavan getting most of the play in the offensive zone, and Baldwin's offense has kind of dried up.
Evenly matched contest thus far between these two teams. Again, Bishop Canavan through traffic. Krakowski's shot up high, saved by Shannon. Now the puck battled and thrown behind the Baldwin net. Wheathorn for Bishop Canavan. Backhanded in front, broken up by Max Millen, and he clears out. Now it's Kinnear down the left wing side. Ducks to avoid a check behind the Bishop Canavan net. Leaves it for Tyler Rush. Rush tried to feed Millen in front, broken up nicely by Lucas Krakowski.
Yeah, Bishop Canavan's defense right now, Don's kind of taking over. They're doing a great job as we get icing on the play from Bishop Canavan. But they've done a really good job. Anytime Baldwin gets in the offensive zone. Bishop Cannon gets that puck, and they're coming right out. They've limited them, not allowed any shots on goal. Speaking of shots on goal, first period, it was 9-5. 9 for Baldwin, 5 for Canavan. But right now, I think Canavan has an edge in this period, shots on goal. The Canavan defense just kind of taking over the early part of the second period.
Players from across the country, the best of high school hockey will be showcased.
Quick shot on goal. Borghini the save for Bishop Canavan. Now he'll come the Crusaders back. TCAC pushes it ahead, unable to get a stick on it, though. Was Rabjack as he tried to redirect that little floater toward the net, or slider toward the net. Good hard work. TCAC in the corner. Leaves it for Kuzma. Kuzma throws it in front on a give and go. TCAC couldn't control it, though. Goes to the near boards to get it. Again, behind the net, cycling low. The Crusaders doing a good job. Rabjack came out in front once, twice, trying to stuff it past Shannon, but could not.
All of a sudden, Baldwin's defense kind of letting up a little bit, and Bishop Canavan taking over. You mentioned the good work behind the net. They're passing the puck to each other, looking for open zones. There was a little opening, but Shannon had the side covered. You can't let them get away with that too often because someone's going to come out of that back. There's going to be a rebound, and the Canavan players are right there. Looking to pounce. Baldwin has to be careful here.
False faceoff to the left of Shannon. Nice big crowd on hand. A lot of Baldwin fans. You get some new blood. They haven't been in the mix in a while.
Yeah, 2 years. 2 years ago they won the Open Championship, Don, and then they haven't been in the playoffs since. First year back.
Yeah, it's been a while since they've been a factor in any Penguins Cup playoff. TCAC. Soft shot from the right point, almost filtered through. Late kick by Shannon to kick that aside. Along the near boards, tied up. Highlanders finally clear out.
Baldwin just...
A lot of time of possession now in the Highlander zone.
Exactly. Baldwin right now, just their program solid enough. They can move it up from the open division. Now it's called Class B and C, but they moved up and the program in good shape. 500, they're a little under 500 in the regular season. And now over 500 with their two playoff wins.
Yeah, they were not a guarantee coming into the final week plus.
Yeah, because
of the regular season of even making the playoffs. A tough loss to Mount Lebanon, a team they were battling for a playoff spot.
Too many struggles, like we said, just 1-4, limped into the playoffs. But who would have thought 2-0 in the playoffs, and they're one win away from a finals berth.
That one win late in the season was the difference. Baldwin ended up holding off by 1 point over Mount Lebanon in the battle for the final playoff spot.
Beat North Hills 5-4, second to last game of the year.
A loss in that one, and they aren't even here. Amazing. Krakowski out of his own zone for Bishop Canavan. He's going to take it himself down the right wing side. Krakowski looks, goes behind the net, still looking, tried to set her in front. Millen sniffed that out, broke it up. Well, he's a good two-way player, Maximilian. There's a big hit at the blue line. D was pushing it ahead, and he just crushed Tomas Krakowski, who was trying to slow him down. Big blast from the point. Knocked aside by Borghini. On the shot from Figura. Now in the slot. Quick shot on goal by Kinnear, and a good save by Borghini, and he holds on.
All of a sudden, Baldwin, just a little bit of play, a little... opening and a big save by Borghini. A man open, wide open in a slot. You talked about Baldwin. How about 4 games left in the season? They lose to Moon. They come back and beat Moon in the playoffs. You mentioned losing to Mount Lebanon, but beating North Hills got them in. They did not play well toward the end, but all of a sudden they've turned it completely around here in the playoffs.
In the Bishop Canavan zone, 1-on-4. For the Highlanders, trying to stick ways through was Tyler Rush, but finally bumped off the puck, just didn't have the numbers. Back to center red, and here come the Crusaders down the right wing side. It's Rabjack. Rabjack tried to stuff it home, and getting a piece of that was Shannon.
Seems like Bishop Canavan really skating well now. Seems they got their legs, and they're the better skating team here in the second period.
Back in that October win, there's a chip shot on goal by Rush, and he just tipped it wide of the cage.
Well, Millen made that play, dodged two checks.
Now coming back in a hurry, Bishop Canavan. Backhand Shannon with a great save, sliding from his right to left as it was a one-time T-catch effort down the slot.
One good scoring opportunity, then another one back the other way. We saw that a lot in the first period, but now it seems like the defenses have really stopped those odd man breaks. But Millen came down, dodged a check, was able to hold on to the puck and throw it into center ice to get a shot, but Borghini was there to save it. Both goaltenders have played well at times.
Dylan DeSimone was between the pipes for Baldwin when they won 4-3 back in October, but Shannon has taken over as the number one guy. Now here comes Baldwin back. Poke checked off the stick of Carlino before he can shoot from the high slot. Good play by Kuzma, who has the puck. Now he misfires on the pass to Lucas Krakowski, and it turns into an icing against the Crusaders. 9:22 left, second period. We're tied at two.
That last play, Canavan, right away, three guys back on defense. They're really making an effort to get back, prevent Baldwin from getting odd man breaks, and they're trying to get an extra man back there. So one of the forwards always back quickly for Bishop Canavan.
Tim Bury handcuffs Borghini with a long shot. We've seen that a couple times, but Borghini able to knock it aside. Back at center red, Baldwin's Carlino.
Look out here.
Gets it up to D. D fires on goal, and a good save by Borghini in the gut, and he holds on.
I'm telling you, when he has the puck, he has a cannon for a shot, and he hides it well. He doesn't dictate where he's going to shoot, when he's going to shoot. He's gliding down that right wing. He's got a man behind him at the point, another man coming. He sees who he has and waits, and all of a sudden he gets inside the circle and fires it. But Borghini was ready and made the save. But the shot comes so quick and so effective, you can't let him have opportunities like that. That's three times for D, wide open, and he hasn't scored yet.
Face off to the left of Borghini, won by the Crusaders, but behind the net, Tyler Rush. He's had a good second period. Got it to Millen, who fanned on a one-timer from the right dot. Now Bishop Canavan back the other way, and they hurry. T-catch go have a breakaway. Comes in on goal centers, and it's broken up. T-catch tries to regroup, and then it slides off his stick, as does Rabchak. And finally, Shannon is able to cover up. One of the Highlander defensemen blew his tire,
yep,
fell down, and that led to a great opportunity.
It could have been a 2-on-none, but that defenseman still was able to get up and use his stick to try to prevent the goal. If the guy who shot the puck would have just watched, he had another guy on his right who ended up getting a chance at it, but neither guy could really get a shot on goal. And T-catch was there, but Cole Shannon able to stop it before it goes in.
Face off to the right of Shannon. Push behind the ball with net, and it's T-Cat. Doing a little skating drill, stops. He is able to skid it down to Rabchak, try to stuff it in off of Shannon. Again, puck played behind the net. Crusaders can't keep it in. Now here come the Highlanders. Back the other way, it's Tyler Rush again down the left wing side. He's knocked off the puck. Nobody there in black and purple to help him out. Now Millen picks it up. Millen fires, and getting a piece of it was Borghini to knock it aside. Kinnear behind the net. Tried to center in front for Millen. Broken up.
Those Kinnear. Two work really well together, Kinnear,
yep,
and Millen. Both puck hogs. Both go for the puck. Both know where to get open.
Crusaders clear. It's going to go all the way down on goal.
Wow, and he misplayed that too, did Shannon?
And it somehow went under his blocker glove, but luckily for Baldwin, it hit off his pad underneath.
I'm kind of surprised. Bishop Canavan's icing the puck there.
Kinnear fires and hit off of one of the Crusader defenders. That's Gian Oliver, and went wide.
All of a sudden, Bishop Canavan's having problems. They're just firing the puck out of the zone. Not the calm, cool, let's break it out. Another icing. Here,
yep,
we go. This is three times in a row. They're just blindly throwing it up. Unless they're trying to hit guys, but the passes just aren't there. Their passing has been bad all game long, and it cost them again. And another faceoff in Canavan territory. And Carlino looks like he's going to take it, but they'll have D just to his right. He's a defenseman, but he'll line up.
Baldwin centered, nobody there. But Bishop Canopy cannot clear. O'Hanlon can't get to the puck. Now the Crusaders have it. And here comes Lucas Krakowski down the left wing side. Could not get around. A Highlander defenseman stood up nicely by Luke Kirk. But the Highlanders can't clear out. Puck dangerously in front. Finally taken by Kirk for Baldwin. Looks for help. And he's going to find it in Carlino. Carlino into the Bishop Canavan zone. Down the left wing side. Fires. Good save by Borghini. Tried to center in front. Broken up. Carlino still has it. Now unexpected pass to Figura. He wasn't ready for it at the right point. Bishop Canavan has it, and they clear out. And another icing against the Crusaders.
Got to gain the red line. Sometime on that one, I thought maybe the ref could have given that one. He was almost at the red line, but another Bishop Canavan icing call. They're just too quick to dump the puck from their own zone, and eventually it's going to cost them. If you watch, like I was going to say, what they do is they'll have one of their snipers just behind the faceoff. They got Kinnear back there. If you win it to him, he's ready for the snapshot.
Bishop Canavan wins. Figura does a nice job keeping it in, at least momentarily, for Baldwin. Now Bishop Canavan will get it out. Kuzma up the ice. Rabnak knocked off the puck. It rolled off his stick to the cage. Cole Shannon covers up as play has stagnated a little bit.
Yeah, first period was pretty even, although Baldwin led 2-1. And Bishop Canavan dominated the early part of this period. All of a sudden, the last 5 minutes, Baldwin the better skating team, Baldwin getting the opportunities, Baldwin better on defense, ebb and flow. These teams evenly matched. They beat each other once each, and both playing well into the playoffs.
Face off to the left of Shannon. Baldwin wins it, and here come the Highlanders. Kinnear, poke check nicely off his stick by Bishop Canavan's Sam Rabchak, who's had a nice game. Crusaders play it in deep. Tamburi for Baldwin. Couldn't handle the puck behind the net. Coughed it up. Highlanders try to clear. Kept in by Kuzma at the right point. Whips it around the boards. It's going to come all the way around to Gian Oliver. Oliver's shot knocked down. Goes to the far boards. A Crusader also knocked down. And finally the puck slithers out of the Baldwin zone as we near 5:10 remaining in period number two. Deadlocked at two. Kinnear back in his own zone, cleaning up, and now leads Millen down the left wing side. Into the Bishop Canavan net. He takes a hit from Oliver.
Again, their defense, Don. Three guys back, making the play. Here they come again.
Krivek flying down the left wing side. Here he comes. In on goal. His shot. Not sure if Shannon got a piece of it or Krivek just missed everything.
I think he missed everything.
With a great opportunity thanks to his speed and shiftiness. Now TCAC, nice move behind the net. Boy, is he tough around the net, isn't he? Turns and fires, knocked down by a Baldwin defenseman. TCAC has it. Oh, he tried to go top shelf. He just lobbed it over the net.
I think it got blocked by the guy in front. Hit his stick and went up over. I'm not sure who was in front there. I think for Baldwin, that was Max Millen.
Kuzma stood up as he tried to enter the zone. Clears out. Bishop Canavan wanted icing, and I think they're finally going to get it.
Yeah. You know, you mentioned the skating ability. All of a sudden, TCAC down there moving around. Nobody around him, but he throws it to the net. Millen laying in front, and I think it hit his stick and went over. And so credit a block shot again, even though really not unintentional. And D goes back and taps Shannon. Shannon makes a couple of big saves, getting to the point in the game where one goal can make the difference.
Well-played game. Penalties to a minimum as the shot deflects up off over the glass and off the netting for Bishop Canavan.
Yeah, three penalties. Baldwin 1-for-1 on the power play, and Bishop Canavan 0-for-2.
Lucas Krakowski on the shot. Hit off of Baldwin's stick and went up. So the faceoff still in the Highlanders zone. Highlanders can't clear. Bishop Canavan with it. They tried to get it in front. Now taking that shot is Matt Wheathorn, but he didn't have the power behind it as he would have trying to set up for the one-timer. He had to go get it. Baldwin able to clear. Now right in front of us. Scrum in front of the boards.
Another block shot by Baldwin.
Battle. Play on, the official says. And they do. And it comes into the Bishop Canavan zone. There it's Tomas Krakowski. Able to clear out. Figueroa back in his own zone for Baldwin on the chase. Plays it high and into the Bishop Canavan bench area.
I'm a little surprised at Bishop Canavan, Don. They started this period so well, and all of a sudden, on defense, everything they do is just clear it deep. And they've taken way too many icings, and they've gone from skating hard, playing great defense, to just blindly throwing it out of their zone.
I think part of it, Mike, I think, is the personnel on the ice, to be honest with you.
That's a good point.
They got some of the big guys out there that I think they're looking to get the rush out of their own zone, whereas if they don't, they just want to make sure they don't get burned in their own zone. Baldwin coming out of their zone. Kinnear lost momentum, had to stop to go back and get the puck, has it again, gets it to Millen. Now it's pushed ahead by Tyler Rush. Off the board, steered behind the net by Borghini, the Bishop Canavan netminder.
Baldwin dumps, nobody chases.
T-catch down the right wing side with some speed. He goes one-on-one against Kirk. And a quick shot in front for Bishop Canavan. Thomas Krivak right on the doorstep, and Shannon had to be sharp to make the save and an icing against Baldwin.
Oh, he went down and hit him right in the pads. He went, tried to go five hole to Krivak. Big save by Shannon. They go in. The defensemen go talk to him. All of a sudden, Baldwin is starting to give up more opportunities, Don. Canavan getting better opportunities. This is kind of how Baldwin played against Moon in the first period. Not a lot of offense. Back on defense a lot. Shannon saving them. And he's made a couple of big saves to keep this game tied at two. But all of a sudden, Bishop Canavan, again, more chances, the better chances have come along here late in this period.
Face off to the left of Shannon. Puck right now on the doorstep, trying to stuff it home, was Weathorn. Could not. Shannon got a pad on it. Now Baldwin on the counterattack. Antonio down the left wing side. And he was definitely trying to go to Kinnear, and the Bishop Canavan defense knew it. Broke it up. Here come the Crusaders back now. Weathorn. Tried to split the defense. It went between the defender's legs on goal. And Shannon covers up another faceoff in the Highlander zone.
I think Baldwin's getting tired, Don. They only have a couple of lines, a couple sets of defensemen, a couple extra guys. If you noticed on that last play, Bishop Canavan had four guys back on defense. Baldwin had two guys on the rush. 2-on-4 with two guys trailing and barely making an effort to get up there and on the offensive rush. I just think that right now, the depth of Bishop Canavan is starting to win out here at the end of this period.
Faceoff won by Bishop Canavan, but they could not keep it in, and then they end up dumping it into their own bench area. So the faceoff will be at center red. 2:23, a second away from complete twos on the scoreboard. And there it is, 2:22 left, second period, tied at two. How about that, Mr. Zady?
Pretty good.
Baldwin has it in front. D couldn't tee it up. He goes and gets it in the corner. D double team, knocked off the puck, and here come the Crusaders. Back the other way. It's T-Cack. He had it stripped away, picked up, though, by Rabchak. Rabchak lost control of the puck. Can the Highlanders clear? They cannot. Now they finally do. T-Cack quickly knocks it back in with a minute 45 to go in the second period.
And we have a lot of that, Don, where the team's clear, the other teams get it, dump it in, a lot of back and forth. You got it, I got it, hockey.
Kuzma's dump in, hit a body, and is knocked down by Baldwin, and here come the Highlanders' D. As Carlino down the left wing, D tries to shoot himself, hit off a skate. Broken up by Bishop Canavan. Doing a nice job defensively. Now T-Cack forwards it up to Krakowski. Krakowski in on goal. He is hooked. Penalty coming up on the Highlanders.
Yep.
I think you're right, Mike. I think the Highlanders.
They're tired.
A little low in the gas tank.
They're tired. Now,
that's the kind of penalty you'll see right there.
I know they don't want to do it, but I'd really think about a timeout here from Baldwin, because now they're going to go on the penalty kill. I think they got some tired bodies. They're trailing the play on defense. They're trailing the play on offense. The last two times down on offense, it's 2-on-4, 2-on-3. Bishop Canavan just has a little bit more oomph, a little bit more giddy up in their step.
And Craig Albert just wants to get out of this period tied, especially now that the Highlanders are shorthanded. They cannot clear. Kept in by Thomas Krakowski, center point. Now he skates in and fires from the left faceoff circle. hit a body and went wide. Center point shot by Kuzma. It'll go. Shannon the save. Rebound. Score.
No goal.
It hit the post and rode the goal line.
And hit the second post. Hit both posts.
Oh, it was Tomas Krakowski who thought he had a rebound goal. He did beat Shannon, but and Shannon
never
can
saw
bank
it.
Both posts.
He never saw it. He was still in the middle of his goal. Never saw the puck. But he was kind of tied up. Backhanded it, hit the inside of the post and crawled along the goal line and touched the other post before they cleared it. Oh my, you're not going to get a better chance than that. And then Bishop Canavan iced the puck. The Baldwin right now, if they can win a faceoff, they can kill some time here.
50 seconds left. If the Crusaders do not score, they'll have about a little under a minute, 45 seconds to go, power play time into the third period. We'll go by the period clock, which says 35. Knocked in deep by Lucas Krakowski around the boards. Baldwin just trying to get it out. Islanders cannot. Crusaders take it behind the net. Center comes back to the left point. There it's Kuzma for Bishop Canavan. Into the corner. 18 seconds left. Back to center point. Kuzma fires, and Shannon got a piece of it to make the save. Through traffic. Crusaders, another shot on goal. Knocked down, and Baldwin able to clear with 6 seconds left. See if Bishop Canavan has time for one more rush. Kuzma, 2 seconds. He'll try to throw it in deep, but it's knocked down. So when we begin the third period, 43 seconds of man advantage time for Bishop Canavan as both teams head off to the locker room. Deadlock, 2-2. At the end of two, it's the PIHL Penguin Cup semifinals only here on the MSA Sports Network.
Who says you can only enjoy breakfast in the morning? And who says you can only enjoy it one type of way? At Dunkin' Donuts, breakfast is delicious any kind of way, any time of day. A breakfast craving can strike any time, whether it's morning, noon, or night. Dunkin' has the perfect combination of breakfast deliciousness to satisfy any craving. Bacon, egg, and cheese on a bagel. Sausage, egg, and cheese on a croissant. Ham, egg, and cheese on an English muffin. All your favorites anytime you want them. Stop by Dunkin' for breakfast anytime. America runs on Dunkin'. Price and participation may vary.
Life is about having the confidence to know you can do anything, right? I get that at Carlo.
I graduated with top awards, but beyond the classroom, Carlo helped me learn a lot about myself.
Carlo brings out the best in you.
I know I'm going to be a fantastic nurse.
I know whatever I come across, I'll be prepared.
I can't think of a better place to start the rest of my life, because at Carlo, I know I matter.
I matter.
I matter.
Enroll at Carlo University. Visit carlo.edu.
MSA Sports broadcasts are now available on both Android and iOS devices. Just navigate to the game of your choice, and on your mobile device, press the arrow or play button. It's that easy. No app needed. No matter where you are, MSA Sports content is available at your fingertips via your iPad, Android phone, iPod, and iPhone. Anytime, anywhere, always there. The MSA Sports Network. When looking to replace your athletic field, choose ProGrass, first in turf. ProGrass has installed over 500 fields in the U.S. Getting the best artificial turf for your field depends on both the product and the partner you choose. That's why architects, athletic directors, and players choose the ProGrass Performance System. ProGrass maintains an active presence in the synthetic turf industry as members of the Sports Turf Management Association and the American Sports Builder Association, and is proud to be recognized as the FIFA preferred manufacturer. Call ProGrass today, 866-270-6003, or visit them on the web at www.prograssturf.com. ProGrass, first in turf.
I'm here to promote the WPIL Romball Report with champion head coach Tim McConnell of Chartiers Valley.
What?
The WPIL Romball Report.
Never heard of it.
You know, weekly show, MSA Sports.
I said, never heard of it. Now you better leave before I get angry, and you won't like me when I'm angry.
Did you see the WPIAL Roundball Report? I love that show.
Why, it's Upper St. Clair coach Danny Holzer. You're obviously a big fan.
Never miss it. I love the insight that Dan Rebel, Jenny Lee, and Sam Small bring.
That's the WPIAL Roundball Report with Don Rebel, Johnny Lee, and Sam Hall every Wednesday night at 6 p.m. on the MSA Sports Network.
Make sure to follow the MSA Sports Network on social media this season for breaking news, scores, links to our articles, and much more. Like us on Facebook at facebook.com/MSA Sports and get in on the conversation with thousands of local sports fans. Follow us on Twitter at MSA Sports and check out our YouTube channel, MSA Sports WPIL, for hundreds of video interviews with local student athletes, game highlights, and more. Whether it's Twitter, Facebook, or our websites, MSA Sports is the place to go for high school sports in Western Pennsylvania.
Robert Morris University Island Sports Complex. They have had for years now a lot of their big games. And this week, this facility on Neville Island hosting all six Penguin Cup semifinals. Also going on tonight, the Division II semifinals out at the Burrell Ice Complex. We will have both of those games as well, audio only. MSASports.net, defending champion Indiana taking on top seed Beaver. That game already underway. Then later on at 9 o'clock, the 2 and 3 seeds, the Meadville Bulldogs and the Carrick Cougars, face off. The champions play in the Division II finals next Monday at 5:30. The winner of this game plays the winner of Armstrong Mars. That's a scheduled 8 o'clock start here on MSA Sports. The two winners meeting next Monday at 8:30. Tomorrow night, the two single-A semifinals here at this facility on MSA. Wednesday night, the two AAA semifinals, all on MSA. Same as next week, the championships next Monday, Division II and AA next Tuesday, single A and AAA. All four games at the new UPMC Lemieux Ice Complex in Cranberry. All four games, video and audio streamed at MSA Sports. .net. Don Rebel, Mike Azadian, we're tied at 2. Baldwin Bishop Cannon, and if I heard the shots on goal right, Mike, that's pretty much dead even as well.
Yeah, 18-17 are the shots in favor of Bishop Cannon. You mentioned Beaver and Indiana. They are underway. No score in that game. But the shots, Bishop Cannon with 18, Baldwin with 17. The shots after one period, I think, were 9-7. So both teams shot the puck on goal a few more times, but low score, low shot totals. It's been a defensive game. 2-2 scoring recap. Ready for the scoring recap?
Sure.
Bishop Kahneman gets on the board first at 3:27. Lucas Krukowski scores. It was a 2-on-1, almost a 2-on-1 as one of the Baldwin players was even, but he was open coming down the left side at the top of the circle. Wrist shot past the goaltender Cole Shannon. Shannon never really saw it, didn't have the angle cut down, bad angle, but a better shot by Krukowski, the assist to Joshua Ruffing. Alec Bosnick again at 3:27. 24 seconds later, Baldwin comes back. Paul Kinnear has a hard shot down low in within about 15 feet. Makes it look easy. Nicholas Antonio with the assist. Antonio with the first goal on a power play against Moon the other night. It is 1-1, and then Baldwin comes back. A little less than 8 minutes later at 11:29, Max Millen on the power play. Tyler Rush and Paul Kinnear with the assists. 2-on-1, Millen left side, low shot again to beat the goaltender Nico Borghini. So that was the score after one period, 2-1. Bishop Canavan in the second period, they were the better team the first 5 minutes, and Alec Bosnick scored a wrist shot in close. 2-on-2 break. That's how they've scored their goals, on the fly, on the break. Daniel Tkach with the assist at 2:53. And that was it for the scoring. 2-2. Bishop Canada with 18 shots. Baldwin with 17. Bishop Canada, the better team in the first 5 minutes of this second period. After an even first period, the mid 5 minutes basically were all Baldwin's. And then all of a sudden, the last five, Bishop Canada dominated. Baldwin is what both myself and Don said. Baldwin was tired. Coming down 2-on-4 breaks. Guys trailing. Back on defense. Baldwin giving up 4-on-2 breaks, 3-on-2 breaks, 5-on-3 breaks, and Baldwin trailing. They're going to have to do something about that, because if they give too many chances to this Bishop Canavan team, they're not going to get a chance at the final. 2-2, Don, in a very well-played game so far.
Living on a lighted stage, approaching the unreal.
How about that?
How about it?
Nothing wrong with a little bit of Rush. Good music selection here, but I like it.
We also have this week the PIAA basketball second round tomorrow and Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday, the quarterfinals, and then Thursday, Friday, Saturday, the PIAA individual wrestling championships, both AA and AAA, at MSASports.net as we are winding down the winter sports season.
And then you get a couple of week vacation,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Put schedules in for hockey, for football,
yeah, don't have
softball,
anything to do.
And baseball and all. Well, we get a couple of week break with not an everyday
broadcast-wise,
but looking forward. Hey, I'm out there today looking around thinking to myself, well, this is baseball weather. We're ready. I'm looking for a
nice,
ball field
it?
To go do a game.
Sweet stuff.
Nothing wrong with that.
All right, we will take a break. Enjoy the music, and when we return, period number three of a dandy in a AA semifinal game. It's the Baldwin Highlanders 2, the Bishop Canavan Crusaders 2. It's the PIHL Penguin Cup playoffs only on the MSA Sports Network.
Hit the ice at Mount Lebanon Ice Center, offering the most comprehensive instructional programs in the area, including hockey, figure skating, and learn-to-skate classes for all ages and ability levels. Classes start soon along with senior and developmental hockey leagues. Mount Lebanon Ice Center also hosts Friday night team skates and Friday after-school skates for younger children. Birthday party packages also available. Mount Lebanon Ice Center, serving the South Hills for more than 35 years. Call 412-561-4363 or go to mountlebanon.org.
Own your piece of hockey history with a Penguins game-used jersey. Visit J&J Distributing at www.jjdistributing.biz and check out one of their largest selections of Penguins game-worn jerseys from your favorite pens, past and present. Or call 724-752-1556. J&J Distributing buys, sells, and trades some of hockey's most prized possessions, including the Penguins game-worn jerseys, Penguins practice jerseys, minor league jerseys, and new and game-used equipment. Browse their inventory today at www.jjdistributing.biz.
Hey, Josh, I hear we have a new coach this season.
Oh, yeah? What do you know about him, Adam?
Well...
Okay, guys, listen up. These 2 points are big tonight. If we want to make the playoffs, we have to be good on face-offs. Remember your assignments. Be strong in our zone, get into the shooting lanes, and stay out of the penalty box.
Coach.
Keep the shift short.
Coach.
What?
There aren't 2 points tonight.
And the show has segments, not shifts.
Can I still yell at the refs?
Coach, you gotta let it go.
Catch the PIHL Power Play Show with Adam Horner, Josh Roundtree, and new edition Kevin Zomanski every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock on MSASports.net.
Inside of the WPIAL Wrestling Circle returns Monday nights at 7 p.m. here on the MSA Sports Network. We have you covered all season long with analysis, coaching, and wrestler interviews. Plus,
we're proud to cover the nation's hotbed of high school wrestling with 2 world champions, 8 returning state champions, and a team that will be going for an unprecedented 10th straight team championship.
Don't miss it. Inside of the WPIAL Wrestling Circle every Monday night at 7 p.m. on the MSA Sports Network.
Right now, when you refer a friend to open a new personal or business checking account at First Commonwealth Bank, you can earn a generous cash reward. It doesn't even have to be a friend. Could be a relative. Could be a Bruins fan. Could be that guy over there with the weird hair thing going on. It doesn't matter. Refer anyone to open an account and it will really pay off for you. They'll even get a cash reward themselves, no matter who they root for. First Commonwealth Bank, member FDIC. Learn more at a local branch or visit fcbanking.com.
With Mike Azadian, I'm Don Rebel. Robert Morris Island Sports Complex on Neville Island. Both the Crusaders and the Highlanders back on the ice. Bishop Canavan and Baldwin tied at 2-2.
Well, we've got a score from the Beaver, Indiana semifinal. Beaver up first. Just 3:20 into the game. Tanner Pelosic scores. The Bobcats, the top seed, they lead 1-0. Dawn, quickly before we get to, they put another 2.5 minutes on the clock. Interesting, as they come back out and warm up. I think for Bishop Canavan, they got to keep the pressure on. Baldwin, I think they realize that Baldwin's a little bit tired. If they keep the pressure on, get a lead, I think they can win this game. Baldwin cannot afford to play from behind. Baldwin, on the other hand, they got to get better on the breaks. They can't score if they're coming down 2-on-4. If you're tired, get off the ice. Get some rest, then get back on. They can't afford to get odd man breaks against this Bishop Canavan team. They're a little bit too deep, is Bishop Canavan, and Baldwin eventually is going to get burned on that. Baldwin's offense kind of dried up from mid-period on, and hopefully for their sake, they got a little bit of rest. Their goaltender has done a pretty good job, Cole Shannon. Right now, the Bishop Canavan 0-for-2 on the power play, but still with a few seconds left, I believe, on the power play.
42
seconds left. Keep the pressure on. They get a goal here, play some good defense. They can get out of here with a win, but this is anybody's game right now, Don. And this Baldwin team, despite being under 500 before the playoffs, now one game over 500, is 17 minutes and a goal away from going to the finals as a true Cinderella team.
And I really don't think the tiredness or the shortness of the Baldwin bench is going to be a factor until maybe late, or
right,
if we were to go to overtime. But right now, they should be fresh as a daisy.
Well, one thing we don't know is how many guys on Baldwin's team played in amateur hockey over the weekend. Was it 3? Was it 5? Was it 6? I've seen cases where guys play 2 or 3 games over a weekend, and now you're playing a playoff game on Monday. We don't know that. Those kind of things I've seen happen over the years, because these kids play on multiple teams. Are they worn out a little bit? They showed it in the second. Let's see what happens here in the third period. We won't know until it happens. But after about a 15, 20-minute rest, Baldwin should be okay here. But key for them, they have to kill this penalty off. Be big if they can win the faceoff. They haven't won a lot of faceoffs. Bishop Canavan has been the better faceoff team here in this game.
Kenny D takes a seat in the sin bin. Bishop Canavan wins the faceoff. They have the puck. 35 seconds left to look. Kravanek behind the defense. And a goal! He could not slide a backhander. May have had Shannon beat, but the puck just swam off his stick. Kravanek. That was Krakowski with that golden opportunity. Lucas Krakowski somehow, some way, got behind the Baldwin defense.
And then Bishop Canavan trying to set up for the power play. And again, a bad pass, and they lose the puck out of the zone.
Bosnick for Bishop Canavan. 5 seconds left into the zone. Down the left wing side. Trying to throw it in front. Broken up by Baldwin. They're going to kill this man advantage. Bishop Canavan 0-for-3 now on the power play. Lucas Krakowski turns, fires one to the net. Knocked down by Antonio. Nick Antonio for Baldwin off the near boards. So we're back to even strength. Tries to headman it up to Kenny D. D out of the penalty box. Could not get the puck. And in his own zone, it's Bosnick for Bishop Canavan to clear.
Yeah, Baldwin killed the rest of that penalty off without too many problems. And now Baldwin ices it. And then we get into the late portions of this game. All those icings could really kill you. All it takes is to win one face off and get a good shot. You got to watch the icings, because they could really hurt you late in this game. Face off to the left of Shannon.
Visit MSASports.net to relive all exciting action from the 2016 Penguins Cup playoffs.
Baldwin wins the faceoff, cannot clear out, at least not for the moment. Bishop Canavan has it. Oh, right off the stick of Rabchak, who is parked in the slot area. He gets it down. Now he has a chance. Blasts it way wide. Kinnear for Baldwin out of the zone. Hits an official. Break for Bishop Canavan. Pushed back in the Baldwin zone. Max Millen in his own zone for the Highlanders. Gets it back to the neutral zone. Rush had it, lost it. Now Antonio has it for Baldwin. Millen into the Bishop Canavan zone down the left wing side. Try to get it to Kinnear. His stick was tied up. And the puck squirts back into the neutral zone.
Now, I'll tell you one thing. Bishop Canavan is determined on defense right now. All five guys back. They are not going to get caught on an odd man break.
Back into the Baldwin zone. Highlanders turned it over, but there to kick it out of harm's way is Kenny D. Now a 2-on-2, but losing the puck is Carlino. Behind the net, Carlino on the chase for the Highlanders. Comes to the right point, Tamburi. Back along the boards, Carlino lets it go. It goes to O'Hanlon, throws it in front.
Wow.
Quick shot on goal, and Borghini makes a save and holds on.
Nice give and go there for Baldwin. Bishop Canavan got caught standing around, but on that 2-on-2, the man was open on the left for Baldwin, but they chose not to pass the puck and didn't get a shot. You got to be unselfish if you want to win hockey games, if you want to win a championship. You can't always be the shooter. Sometimes you got to take the assist and let somebody else take the shot that's wide open, and Baldwin chose not to do that.
Crusaders can't clear it out first time on the effort. Krukowski, now we have a penalty coming up. And that becomes important, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. So far, special teams, Bishop Canavan 0-3, Baldwin 1-1, and this is going to go against
Bishop Canavan.
Bishop Canavan, so Baldwin with only their second power play. Wasn't sure who it was on because two guys collide. I don't know if it's a high stick or what the call was. I didn't see.
Elbowing on Gian Oliver.
That's one thing that they, the officials in the last 2 years, Don, when the elbow comes above the shoulder and goes near the head, that gets called because of the concussion protocols all the time.
The Bishop Canada, now number 29.
So the Highlanders.
Oliver, 2 minutes for elbowing.
Trying to stay perfect with a man advantage, looking for their second tally on their second attempt. But it comes to the left point right through the skates of Kenny D all the way back into the Baldwin zone. D goes off the boards and he gets it to Kinnear. Kinnear down the left wing side, dangerous and open ice, stops at the left faceoff circle. Looks, finds D trailing. D fires a wrister wide of the cage.
Well,
and it's
going to
come all the way out. And look out to shorthanded 2-on-1. Krukowski down for Bishop Canavan. Floats a pass over, and the shot goes wide by Alec Bosnick.
They're trying to pick corners instead of putting it on net. Trying to pick corners. They put it on net, they might score or get a rebound. Got to put the puck on net to score.
Good shorthanded opportunity there for the Crusaders. Now pushing it ahead, Tyler Rush. Diving on his belly, Borghini to poke check it away from Rush. Along the far boards, pressure by Kinnear, but the Crusaders able to get it and clear out. Millen now. Big blast from the right point. Gloved aside by Borghini.
Yeah, he can see it. He's going to stop it. There's no doubt about that.
And the Crusaders cleared the length of the ice. 41 seconds left on the man advantage. Just under 13 minutes left in regulation. Tied at 2. Millen gets it up to D. D in. Split the defense. Good shot on goal. Borghini makes the save.
Yeah, three guys on him. He created his own shot. He's just smart. He's calm, cool, easy. He'll play at the next level somewhere.
Tamburi back in his own zone under duress around the boards to Kenny D. Or excuse me, to Max Millen. Millen went backwards. Now a turnover. Rabchek has it. His shot hit his stick and goes over. Boy, Tamburi put it right on Rabchek's stick.
Hesitation. If he just one times it, they might get a goal. But that couple second hesitation, Don, Baldwin player gets his stick in there and blocks a shot. You gotta get rid of the puck at this level. You can't wait to make fancy plays. Baldwin's playing tough on defense, and they're not going to let you shoot.
Face off to the left of Shannon. Baldwin wins it, and Kirk pushes it ahead to O'Hanlon. O'Hanlon dumps it in deep behind the Bishop Canavan net. There, Krakowski, Thomas Krakowski, trying to clear out. Now he'll get it again. Feathers it behind the boards. Bain can't get it for Bishop Canavan. Krakowski again on the chase. Tries to overpower Luke Kirk to get the puck. Comes to the right point for Baldwin. And the power play is now over. Islanders 1-for-2. But they have the puck in the Baldwin zone, and Kirk threw it through the goal mouth. No harm done. Comes to the left point. Figura to Kirk. Kirk, oh, it's passed to O'Hanlon. Oh, got caught up in O'Hanlon's skates. He couldn't get a good shot off.
Yeah, didn't missed everything.
O'Hanlon again, though. This line doing a nice job after the man advantage. Goes around the boards to Carlino. Behind the net, Carlino along the far boards loses the puck. Now a steal. It's Rush. Rush fires, and a good save by Bergini. Now another clearing attempt knocked down by Figura, kept in for Baldwin. Highlanders with some momentum.
All of a sudden, Borghini giving a big rebound. Good thing his defense was there.
Now Baldwin comes back 2-on-2 if they hurry. Krakowski fires, hit a stick, and trickles to the net where Shannon makes the save as Figura got a piece of that one.
All of a sudden, Baldwin the better team in the first few minutes. Now we're at 10 minutes 53. They've really come on. Offense strong, a lot of shots. Couple of big saves by Borghini. D with a big shot. Milan playing well. We'll see if they can keep this up for the whole third period.
Face off to the right of Shannon. One by Bishop Canavan. Oliver with a shot. Shannon got a piece of it.
So important winning those faceoffs. That's what happens.
Rush back for Baldwin. 1-on-1. Goes wide right, looking for a trailer, and is passed behind Tamburi. Crusaders can't clear out. Now they do.
Baldwin fans in front of us not happy. I think Kinnear got put on his wallet. But when you have the puck, you're allowed to be checked. And Bishop Canavan finishing their checks. I think Bishop Canavan a little bit better the checking team here tonight. They finish their checks, but they don't do it consistently enough. And then that's when they get caught. And then they start doing it again. And then Baldwin gets better offensively. But you got to keep finishing those checks. Keep them honest.
Face-off outside the Bishop Canavan zone. Long shot from center red by Kenny D. Gloved by Borghini, and he holds on. So face-off now in the Crusader zone.
Baldwin, as you mentioned, 1-for-2 on the power play. 0-for-3 is Bishop Canavan. So special teams, slight edge to Baldwin. For the
2016 Penguins Cup. Crusaders win the faceoff, get the puck out, and here comes TCAC down the left wing side. With the puck goes his backhander, tried to slide it in front for teammate Thomas Krivak, broken up. Now it's big Tomas Krakowski behind the net. Double team knocked off the puck. TCAC comes to help for the Crusaders. Try to get it in front and unable to tee it up with Thomas Krivak, and Baldwin clears out. TCAC at center red for Bishop Canavan. He's knocked off the puck. Rush, nice little touch pass. Right side, it's D. D fires on goal, and Bergini the save.
A backhand for D with a guy on him, still got it on goal. He, I think, has about 5 or 6 shots on goal, 3 or 4 that have just missed, but hasn't dented the scoreboard.
Krakowski clears out of his own zone for Bishop Canavan. But Baldwin Millen carried it and had his pocket picked by TCAC from behind, who feathers a nice backhand pass to Lucas Krakowski into the Baldwin zone. He waits for help, but 4 black jerseys back, and it's Max Millen around the boards and out for Baldwin. All the way the length of the ice, and an icing call against the Highlanders with 9:07 left.
Bishop Canavan caught in a line change, one man in against 4, as you said, and just bad luck, and then all of a sudden one man gets the puck back and ends up icing the puck by accident.
Face off to the right of Shannon. One by Bishop Canavan. Cosma throws it behind the net. Bosnick has it for Bishop Canavan. Bosnick gets a shot off, hit his own teammate, Matt Wheathorn, in the slot. And now Baldwin back on the counterattack and icing as O'Hanlon took it wide and had teammates in the zone before the puck.
All of a sudden, we've slowed down. Pretty good start to this period with the Bishop Canavan power play. And Baldwin gets the power play in the last couple of minutes. A lot of stoppages. Kind of ground to a halt. It's become a defensive game all of a sudden. Neither team wants to give up any advantage.
Face off outside the Crusader zone. And they play give and take in the neutral zone. It's finally dumped behind the Bishop Canavan net. Crusaders, Patrick Bain, pressured, still has it behind the net. Off the boards, Lucas Krakowski skates out of the zone. Cross-ice pass misfires as he was trying to hit Alec Bosnick. Baldwin pushes it back. Patrick Bain. Now Baldwin has it. Poked off the stick to Baldwin's Jacob Dorrance out there now. And Bishop Canavan on the counterattack. Bosnick knocked off the puck. Dorrance, good pressure on Krukowski. Knocked it off his stick. And Luke Kirk able to get it back to the neutral zone. And a penalty coming up.
I think that's against
Crusaders.
Yeah, high stick. Oh, head contact. They're going to call head contact, I think, because the check is the Baldwin player got it out of zone. That's not good for Bishop Canavan. That might be 5 minutes.
It's Gian Oliver again. That's his second penalty of the period.
When you go up above the shoulders now, I've seen this all year, the last 2 years. Every game I've done, you go up over the shoulders, they're calling it every single time. These referees don't want to be responsible for someone getting concussions. And now they're going to explain it to the bench. The bench for Canavan not happy. But, hey, you come in on a check and you come in stick and elbow high, they're going to call it. And it's been that way all for the last couple of years. And Bishop Canavan could get burned. Baldwin on another power play.
2 minutes on the board for the Highlanders to work with. Kevin Paulus, the first-year coach for Bishop Canavan, following in the large footsteps of MSA Sports Zone Kevin Zomanski, who is in the house as a spectator.
I'm talking all the Bishop Canavan fans.
Baldwin sets up on the man advantage. Looking for the go-ahead goal. Left point shot, knocked down by Borghini. Puck played behind the net. Highlanders in control. With it is D at the left point. D, a pass hard for Millen. He can't handle it, and it's broken up and cleared by Kuzma.
That penalty, 2 minutes for head contact, 10-minute misconduct.
So they'll be without Oliver the rest of regulation. Hoping the 2 minute minor doesn't cost them. Long pass deflects off Rush, and Borghini had to be sharp to make sure he steered it aside. Again, the Crusaders clear the length of the ice. Shannon comes out, knocks it around the boards. D, a little casual kick, and now taking it over is Lucas Krakowski. Krakowski around two guys, but finally stood up by D, who got that play all started with, a casual play in his own zone.
Baldwin got lazy.
Kinnear down the left wing side, lost the puck. Poke checked. Well, nice job by Millen to keep it in for Baldwin. But his pass in front broken up and cleared by Lucas Krakowski. He's done a marvelous job on this penalty kill.
Yeah, the passing just not there for Baldwin. They're just a little discombobulated here. Last 20 seconds.
Kinnear down the right wing side into the Bishop Canavan zone. He's going to go wide. Lost the puck momentarily. Rush tries to come and help him, but Bishop Canavan clears.
Good penalty kill. Very good penalty kill. 7 seconds left. I don't think they're going to get a goal here on the power play.
Well, the Highlanders will be 0-0 for 2 here in the third period. 1-for-3 as the penalty is over. 5:45 left in regulation. A turnover by Bishop Canavan. Rush couldn't control the bouncing puck right in front of the Bishop Canavan net. Now Rabicek back for Bishop Canavan. Throws it in front. Unable to get there. T-catch. Broken stick on the ice. It belongs to Baldwin, so almost like a man advantage here for Bishop Canavan if they hurry. But a nice job defensively. Max Millen in his own zone for Baldwin. Throws it to the middle of the ice. Bishop Canavan able to keep it in. As Baldwin cannot clear out. One-timer in the slot by Sam Hrabchak. And a good save by Shannon. And he holds on.
And I'll tell you what. The player got to the bench. Just lost his stick. But, again, Baldwin lazy with the clears. Just little chips. But Bishop Canavan fast. They get up. They step up, they keep the puck in, they get an advantage. There's a man wide open in the slot, and a big opportunity, but a better save by Shannon.
Face off to his left. Won by Baldwin. Face offs now become very important. Clearing pass, knocked down by Bishop Canavan. Shot from the right point, hit off somebody and went wide. That shot by Tomas Krakowski. Now centered in front, knocked away by Baldwin. Krakowski has it, fakes a shot, goes into the corner. Now a pass deflects up behind the net for Bishop Canavan. Crusaders still have it, though, in control. Center point, shot, hit a body, went wide from Kuzma. Good hard work by Bosnick for Bishop Canavan on this shift. He has it back in the neutral zone. Dumps it into the Baldwin zone. Highlanders have it. Kenny D. Tried to get it ahead to Dominic Carlo. Knocked out of the air by Bishop Canavan. Big hit at center red. Sends a Crusader flying. Bosnick has it for Bishop Canavan. Down the near boards. Bosnick still in possession. Tied up by Tamburi. Puck's loose. Comes to Rabchak. He turns. Fires it behind the net. O'Hanlon can't get it out. Kuzma has it. Kuzma fires. And a right pad save by Shannon. Nearing 4 minutes left in regulation. Tied at two. Baldwin, Bishop Canavan. Berth in the AA finals at stake. One of the Crusaders in a scrum is going to skate off. That's Bosnick. He's
might
just
be
exhausted.
More exhausted. Both. Yeah, both of these guys. A lot of these guys have been out there a long time.
That's a smart move. Get a fresh player on the ice while the puck is in the other team's zone. Krivak can't keep it in. He is the fresh man. Now it's Figura. There's going to be some tired Baldwin players. Tamburi dumps it in deep and the Highlanders go for a line change. 3:33 left, tied at two. Big hit by Figura sends Krivak to the ice.
Fans like that. I think they should like goals a little bit better than hits.
And a hand pass called against the Highlanders, I believe. Although now they're pointing face off. Let's see where the face off is. Oh, they're going to bring it down.
That's against
out of the zone, so it's against the Crusaders.
Canada. Yeah, because defensively, you're allowed on defense, but they didn't. Yeah, it's interesting. 3:27 to go. Obviously, team that scores here late in the period, if they do, just has to play a little bit of defense.
Well, we're getting to the point now.
One goal could win it.
Yeah, I mean, if we get a goal in regulation, it's going to be tough for the other team to come back. Emotionally and also just time-wise.
The checking has really picked up too, man. The defense, a lot of fights in the corner. The physicality's really ramped up.
Thomas Krukowski for Bishop Canavan wins the scrum on the near boards. He's going to dump it in. Knocked down by Baldwin's Nick Antonio. And he gets it up the ice. Kinnear right off. He didn't get all the shot. It almost fooled.
Yeah, it was like changeup. It was a changeup as it deflected in.
And then a follow-up shot by Millen stopped by Borghini. Sharp twice. Rush for Baldwin. Gets it up to Kinnear. Kinnear.
Lost
not sure
puck.
What happened.
I think he lost the puck or tried to pass it to Millen.
He just let it go when Bishop Canavan now has
it. Yeah. Excellent opportunity passed.
Here comes TCAC down the right wing side. Overskates the puck. In the Baldwin zone. Highlanders cannot clear, though. Bosnick behind the net. Still Bishop Canavan as we're down to 2 minutes left in regulation. To the right point. Shot through traffic. Never got to the net. Knocked on. Wheathorn directs it to Lucas Krukowski. Krukowski along the far boards. Wheeling and dealing. Finally taken away by Max Millen, who cannot clear. Kept in and shot wide from the center point by Wheathorn.
Baldwin's tired again, Don.
Wheathorn working hard, looking. Oh, tried to get it to Kuzma. Knocked away, but not cleared by Baldwin. It is Tomas Krukowski behind the net.
Millen and Kinnear been out there a long, long time.
Look out in front, man. There's shots! And Shannon with the right pad save. Wheathorn's shot knocked down before it got to the net. Finally, Baldwin able to clear. All Bishop Canavan right now as we're down to a minute 10 left in regulation. Left point, Kuzma, shot, block, comes right to Krivak. Krivak trying to tee it up, shot, block. Excellent job by Rush. Krivak trying to get it back. Rush has it. Can he get it up to Kinnear? He cannot. Kinnear would have had a breakaway. How about that for dramatics?
Tell me about it. And Kinnear's, I've been out there forever.
Tee catch and front shot, score! Tomas Krivak alone in front. Bishop Canavan takes the lead with 47 seconds left.
Baldwin's star players were out there for 3 minutes.
Milan, Kinnear, they got lazy on defense. They couldn't get the puck out. They couldn't get to the bench. They had a chance to get to the bench two different times.
They didn't get lazy. They just got tired.
Okay.
I wouldn't say lazy.
Yeah, okay. But at times, they just couldn't get the puck out. They were cruising at center ice. They had a chance to get off the ice twice, and they didn't take it. They come back, and Bishop Canavan just outworked them. Bishop Canavan earned this. I think Baldwin got a little tired and just wouldn't get their guys off the ice. That really, really hurts them. And Bishop Canavan, at the end of the period, they're going to assist the Krivak.
That should be the other way around, should it not?
I think Krivak got the goal. I'm pretty sure.
Wasn't it 21 who shot it? I know what they said. I thought it was the other way around. I thought so too. They might change that. I thought it was T-Catch who brought it in, got it in front to Krivak, who buried it past Cole Shannon.
Up high too. Got it up over his pads. Didn't let him get a glove or a blocker on it. Still waiting for Point Streak to put it up, but Bishop Canavan just kept changing lines, getting fresh bodies out there, putting the pressure on. Baldwin couldn't clear the puck. They had numerous opportunities. Once they got it to center ice, they didn't get off the ice. They desperately needed an icing. They tried three times to ice it, but Bishop Canavan stopped the puck at center ice. Their defense did a great job. Baldwin then couldn't get these players off the ice. They got tired. Bishop Canavan fresh troops in, and they just kept working and working and working. And Bishop Canavan right now 47 seconds away from a finals berth. And they're going to give, they say, Daniel Tkach with Krivak the assist. But I agree with you.
I apologize, but I'd love to see the video again because I thought it was Tkach down the right wing side, got it in front to Krivak, and it was Krivak that beat Shannon.
I agree with you. I don't think Tkach was anywhere near the net. I agree. Big faceoff win for Bishop Canavan here.
Krivak's going to be the first to touch it back behind the ball with net. Highlanders want to get the puck up, and they get Shannon off. And here they come, and here comes Shannon out. Pass in the middle of the ice, picked off by Bishop Canavan. Empty net for the Crusaders. Can they get there? Yes! A diving effort by Lucas Krakowski was able to slide it into the empty net before he went headfirst into the boards.
Wow, what a goal. What a goal. He was almost behind the goal line, and he got that stick on it. I'm telling you what, Baldwin just couldn't get it out of the zone, couldn't get the pass up, couldn't find the open man. Bishop Canavan intercepts it, and that's pretty much going to be all she wrote. Baldwin, great effort, great playoffs, but just couldn't get it done. Just got a little bit too tired, didn't have enough oomph, didn't have the depth that Bishop Canavan did, couldn't win the big faceoffs toward the end. Bishop Canavan finally found a way.
The Bishop Canavan goal, scored by number 7, Lucas Krakowski.
Icing against Bishop Canavan off the faceoff. 18 seconds left.
That's a penalty. Someone took a penalty. Tyler Rush hit a guy from behind. He gets called.
Baldwin's had a tremendous run here in the postseason. Why scar it by being stupid here in the last few seconds?
And indeed took the puck and it fired it into the boards. I know you're upset, guys. Now Millen talking on someone, and they're going to – if I'm the referees, I get guys out of there. Millen's going to the penalty box too. Just dumb. No, that's not smart. You lost the game, be a sportsman. That's unfortunate.
It was a well-played game. Very few penalties. And just because you're going to lose it, and it hurts, it stings.
Stinks, right?
Heartbreak fashion. But
be a man. Be a man and be smart and just don't.
There's no rule in this game that says because you're about to lose a game, you got to act like a goof.
Exactly. Rush cross-checked the guy from behind. He got called for it. And Baldwin wants to try to take revenge out. You lost. That's all there is to it. Game over.
Crusaders, 8 seconds left. They're going to dump it into the corner. There to get it is Rabchak, throws it in front. Good save by Shannon. They're just going to let the time tick off. A tremendous postseason run for Baldwin from the 9 seed comes to an end. In dramatic fashion, Bishop Canavan, a pair of goals in the final minute the difference as the Crusaders move on. And next Monday at the UPMC Lemieux Ice Complex, we'll play either Armstrong or Mars for the AA PIHL Penwood Cup title. They'll line up and shake hands. And when we return, we'll give you the scoring recap and the Management Science Associates 3 stars of the game. Marvelous one to get semifinal week going. Bishop Canavan 4, Baldwin 2. It's the PIHL Penwood Cup playoffs here on the MSA Sports Network.
Life is about having the confidence to know you can do anything, right? I get that at Carlo.
I graduated with top awards, but beyond the classroom, Carlo helped me learn a lot about myself.
Carlo brings out the best in you.
I know I'm going to be a fantastic nurse.
I know whatever I come across, I'll be prepared.
I can't think of a better place to start the rest of my life, because at Carlo, I know I matter.
I matter.
I matter.
Enroll at Carlo University. Visit carlo.edu.
Who says you can only enjoy breakfast in the morning? And who says you can only enjoy it one type of way? At Dunkin' Donuts, breakfast is delicious any kind of way, any time of day. A breakfast craving can strike any time, whether it's morning, noon, or night. Dunkin' has the perfect combination of breakfast deliciousness to satisfy any craving. Bacon, egg, and cheese on a bagel. Sausage, egg, and cheese on a croissant. Ham, egg, and cheese on an English muffin. All your favorites anytime you want them. Stop by Dunkin' for breakfast anytime. America runs on Dunkin'. Price and participation may vary.
When looking to replace your athletic field, choose ProGrass, first in turf. ProGrass has installed over 500 fields in the U.S. Getting the best artificial turf for your field depends on both the product and the partner you choose. That's why architects, athletic directors, and players choose the ProGrass Performance System. ProGrass maintains an active presence in the synthetic turf industry as members of the Sports Turf Management Association and the American Sports Builder Association, and is proud to be recognized as the FIFA preferred manufacturer. Call ProGrass today, 866-270-6003, or visit them on the web at www.prograssturf.com. ProGrass, first in turf. The only place to turn to listen and watch the 2016 PIHL Penguins Cup playoffs is right here on the MSA Sports Network. We have audio and video coverage from the first round all the way through the high school hockey championships. Plus, we will have nightly recaps of all the action. The broadcasts, the interviews, and the write-ups of the PIHL Penguins Cup playoffs are only here on the MSA Sports Network.
We welcome you back to the Robert Morris University Island Sports Complex and our post-game show. Semifinal game number one is in the books. And in a dandy, the Bishop Canavan Crusaders hold off the Baldwin Highlanders 4-2 and advance to the Penwood Cup Championships, where they will play the winner of our next game here on MSA Sports, Armstrong against Mars. It's first start with the scoring recap, Mike Azadian.
First period, Bishop Canavan scored first. Lucas Krukowski at 3:27. Joshua Ruffing and Alec Bosnick with the assist. Krukowski. Left side, top shelf, came down the left side wide open. Nobody came to him. He beat Cole Shannon. It was 1-0. A mere 24 seconds later, Paul Kinnear scored for Baldwin to tie it up. Nicholas Antonio with the assist. It was at 3:51. Low, hard shot from the left side, tied it at 1. 8 minutes later, Max Millen scored on the power play. Baldwin is up 2-1. Tyler Rush and Paul Kinnear with the assist. It was 2-1 going into the second period. Only scoring in the second period, Bishop Canavan tied it at 2:53 early on. Alec Bosnick. Bosnick, wrist shot in close, 2-on-2 break. Both of their goals on breaks. And Daniel Tikak with the assist at 2:53. Into the third period, both teams had power play chances. Both teams could not get past the other goaltender, both Borghini and Shannon, with key saves. Finally, at 16:13, less than a minute to play, Daniel Tikak, that's who they're going to give credit for it. Thomas Krivak with the assist. We thought it was Krivak getting the goal.
I am standing by, again, until I see the video archive, I am standing by the fact that, unless I took, again, I'm old, my eyes are deceiving
me. I think what happened is
The referee goes over and says either the referee mixed it up or the official scorer mixed it up, but we're pretty sure that it's
yeah, that's what I said, yeah.
We're pretty
agrees.
Sure it's Krivak.
Go Krivak.
Krivak from Tkach at 16-13.
Yes.
Then with an empty net, 23 seconds later, Lukasz Krukowski diving to stop the puck, throws it toward the net, and from an impossible angle, empty net, assist by Krivak. So Krivak with a goal and assist in the last minute. Final shots, Baldwin 27, Bishop Canavan 26.
All right, so yeah, Matt Vandriak, who's calling the second game, says my eyes don't deceive me, so they screwed up. It was Krivak from Tkach on that game-winning goal.
Does that change our three stars
with
then?
With under a minute left. No, because Tkach, you know, set him up.
Okay.
A nice job bringing the puck down the right-wing side and got it over to him. And while there is no star for Thomas Krivak, he obviously is a star in a way because if he doesn't score, we're still playing. Let's check our three stars sponsored by the Management Science Associates.
Well, number three, we're going to give it to Daniel Tkach. He had the big assist, assist to tie it, and the assist on the winning goal. Besides that, he played a tremendous game on defense, moving the puck, good puck movement, solid defense. He is your number three star, Daniel Tkach from Bishop Canavan. The number two star, Paul Kinnear from Baldwin, had a goal early on to tie it, had an assist. Overall, great game for Paul Kinnear, the number two star from Baldwin. The number one star, Lukasz Krukowski, had the opening goal and had the empty net goal from Bishop Canavan. Lukasz Krukowski is your Management Science Associates player of the game and number one star.
Congratulations to the Crusaders. They improved to 17-6-1 and will await the winner of Mars and Armstrong coming up. That game Monday, 8:30 at the new UPMC Lemieux Sports Complex out in Cranberry. Video and audio stream here on MSA Sports Network. And a big, big tip of the cap to Craig Albert and his Highlanders. We're big fans of the underdog story in any postseason. Baldwin barely getting into the playoffs. They knock off Hampton, a good Hampton team. They upset top seed Moon, and they darn near knocked out Bishop Canavan to advance to the finals, but not to be. A great postseason run. Baldwin's season ends at 12-12-1.
At in Warrendale, Beaver and Indiana in the semifinals. Beaver in the second period up 3-0 over the defending champs.
All right, we thank our videographer, Chris Lackner, for what we hope is a job well done. And he could have given me the thumbs up to say, yes, it was Krivak, but he never did, so we'll let him go on that. Dave Fry and the folks here at the PHL for their help. And for my broadcast partner, Mike Azadian, I'm Don Rebel. Final score in the Dandy, the Bishop Canavan Crusaders 4, the Baldwin Highlanders 2.
The 2016 PIHL Penguins Cup High School Hockey Playoffs on the MSA Sports Network have been sponsored by the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena, by J&J Distributing, by First Commonwealth Bank, by Carlo University, by ProGrass, by Dunkin' Donuts, and by Management Science Associates. You can follow the high school hockey postseason and all the winter sports playoffs by logging on every day to www.msasports.net. The preceding has been a special presentation of the Management Science Associates Sports Network.